Bedford. Hello, music fans. Welcome to another exciting episode of Bedford Backstage. Today, we have another young celebrity, and his name is Colin O'Toole. I bet you can't figure out what instrument he plays. Let's find out. Hello, Colin. Welcome to Bedford Backstage.
Hello.
So, what instrument is that you've got there?
I have a trumpet.
Oh, very exciting. And how old are you?
I'm 11 years old.
Okay, so that means you're in sixth grade. What school?
JGMS.
Excellent. How are you liking JGMS this year?
It's very nice.
Did you go to Nature's Classroom?
Yes.
Was it fun?
Yes.
Good. Okay. That wasn't even in the pre-interview. I was just asking questions on the spot. So you play the trumpet, and you've been playing for how long?
5 years.
5 years. So is this the same trumpet you've been playing since you were in first grade?
No. This one's actually, I got this for my birthday.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
Did you start on a smaller trumpet, or are trumpets pretty standard size?
Trumpets are pretty standard size. I originally had a student horn that I use in the sixth grade band.
Oh, okay.
And then I think I had a cornet, a flugelhorn, and then I got my great-grandfather's trumpet. Now I have this.
Oh, wow. What was your great-grandfather's trumpet like?
It was cool. This, a little bit older and not silver-plated.
Oh. Okay. Was that fun to play on something your grandfather had played on?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little piece of family history. And you play in the JGMS band.
That's right? Correct.
But this is not the first band you've played in. You also played in the fifth grade band. Mm-hmm. Now, most kids are only in the fifth grade for 1 year, so they only get one shot at the fifth grade band. How many years did you play in the fifth grade band for?
3 years.
3 years, people. Amazing. Nice job, Colin. And I hear you sing, too.
That's correct. I do sing.
In the sixth grade chorus?
Mm-hmm.
They should have let you sing in the fifth grade chorus for 3 years, too.
I sang in the fifth grade chorus for 1 year.
In fifth grade. Okay. Well, I guess you can't be everything to everyone, Colin, right? And, oh, here's an exciting fact. You're not just in the sixth grade band. You also have another band you're in on Tuesday and Thursday afternoons. What band is that?
It's the JGMS Jazz Band.
And what instruments come and join you for jazz band practice?
It's typically anything you could think of. A violin, a flute, a saxophone, piano, anything.
That's surprising. I thought you were just going to list a bunch of brass instruments. Flute, violin?
Yeah. I guess. We have flute. Wow. We have a ukulele, too.
What? A ukulele, too. So, kids out there at JGMS, literally any instrument is welcome at jazz band practice. Now, I asked if you played in the fall concert, and you said no. So, note to jazz band members, I will be sitting in the audience this spring expecting a performance of the jazz band. Right, Colin? Can you make that happen? Yes. The answer was yes. You can make that happen. After practicing all year, twice a week, you guys have to show off your skills. And how cool will it be to see all those instruments? You're going to inspire so many children. Yes, you will. Okay, now you take private lessons. Who's your private lessons teacher?
Trisha Gately.
And how long have you been studying with her?
Probably a few months now.
Oh, okay. Just a few months. Still testing her out.
Yeah. I had one private lessons teacher for a couple years before.
Mm-hmm.
He was Mr. Savage.
Oh,
That's what I called him.
Yeah. But then you got too good for him.
No, I think I stopped taking private lessons for probably about 2 years.
Yeah. Really? Okay. Well, I'm glad you're back at it. It's exciting. And your church in Littleton, St. Catherine of Alexandria, gets to hear you play trumpet also, right?
Yep.
When do you do that during the year?
It's usually Easter.
In Easter. Oh, so if you belong to St. Catherine of Alexandria, you can hear Colin play trumpet there as well. And what genres of music do you enjoy playing?
I enjoy playing almost everything I like. Classical, jazz. That's about it, yeah.
Yeah, and what jazz musician do you like the best?
I like Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder. How fun is that? You called him a jazz rock fusion, right? Yep. That's the genre he plays? Wow. I've never heard of jazz rock fusion. That's very fun. I didn't realize that's what Stevie Wonder played. So you're going to be playing a song for us on your trumpet. You have no sheet music because you said you memorized it, which is very impressive. I have memorized Jingle Bells on the piano. Not nearly as impressive. And what are you going to be playing for us?
I'm going to play Return of the Prodigal Son.
By Stanley Turrentine. And you said a famous jazz musician did a rendition of this. Who was that?
That was Miles Davis.
All right, Miles Davis. Let's see the Colin O'Toole version of Return of the Prodigal Son. Welcome back to Bedford Backstage. Colin, nice job on that trumpet piece.
Thank you.
Very impressive. Do you like to improvise when you play, or do you like to just sort of play the notes straight?
I like to improvise sometimes. Really depends on the song.
All right. When it's called for.
Yeah.
Paula, our producer and director, Paula Gilardi, has some questions we ask each of our talented musicians at the end. I guess they don't have to all be musicians, but our talent, our Bedford talent at the end of each episode. So hopefully you've studied these questions. What, Colin, is your favorite word?
My favorite word would probably be trumpet.
Oh, ah, that's nice. And what is your least favorite word?
My least favorite word would probably be literally.
Literally, I like it. Does it annoy you when people use the word literally incorrectly when they don't mean literally?
Unless they're somewhat exaggerating, then it annoys me.
Do you listen to Weird Al Yankovic?
No.
You should check out his song Word Crimes because he has a whole little segment in there about literally. And I think you'd enjoy it. What sound or noise do you love?
I like the sound of when waves hit a bank.
Oh, that's nice. That's very relaxing. So what sound or noise do you hate?
I hate it when a chalkboard, like somebody uses a chalkboard.
And it makes that scratching noise?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty awful. Does it also bother you when people cut food on a plate and it makes that same noise, like a knife on a plate? General intolerance for that terrible noise. Get it? What profession, other than playing trumpet or singing, would you like to try?
I don't know. It's a good question. I haven't really thought about it yet.
Yeah, Paula has great questions. Nothing?
Not really.
No. Well, okay. That's fine. What profession would you not like to try? Surely you've thought of this one.
I would never like to be the people who have to work in sewers.
Okay.
Because they have to deal with all these clogs, and it's not fun.
Yeah, that does seem like a pretty disturbing job.
Yeah.
Like, when you get home, you must, like, shower in Purell. What is your favorite Bedford Farms flavor?
My favorite Bedford Farms flavor is probably cookie dough.
Oh, they do make excellent cookie dough. Nice, nice choice. Okay, now let's pretend we have a telephone and it can call anyone in the world, living or dead. Who would you call and what would you say?
That's a good question. I think that I might call George Washington.
Okay.
To tell him to ask him about his success.
Oh.
How were you so successful and all your great feats?
Nice. Will you ask him if the wigs were itchy that they used to wear, too? Just for me. Say, a friend of mine wants to know, were those wigs itchy?
Yeah, I'd probably ask him. All right. Depends on the material, what they're made out of.
Yeah, right? Doesn't it? So maybe as a profession you'd like to try, you could do politician.
I could try being a politician. I would not be successful at all, but yeah.
All right. No, it. You don't think so?
No.
You're pretty charismatic. You don't think so?
I don't think I could really be a politician.
All right. Okay. Well, I'll keep thinking of a good profession for you to try. All right. Well, we'll have to put an addendum on this episode when Colin thinks of a profession he'd like to try. If you have suggestions for a profession Colin should try, we could probably just email the station or go on Twitter and tweet the station, let us know. Mm. Yeah, maybe we'll get some interesting responses. Colin, is there anything you want to add?
Not really.
Well, let's thank all of our viewers for tuning in today and for watching this fascinating, informational episode of Bedford Backstage. And don't forget, if you have a profession you would like Colin to try, just email into the station. Paula will pass it along to him. We hope everybody has a great day. Thanks for watching.